Hello, beautiful people of YouTube. Welcome back. This week, we are talking about a necessarily selfish message that is called you gotta protect your energy. I first want to address the Christian attitude when it comes to this topic. So hear me out, everyone. Listen, as a believer, you know, you're like, oh, it's like my duty to save people. It's my duty to, you know, get people to know Jesus. And like, this is my responsibility. And this is like my faith and all of that's great. Not knocking that, perfectly fine. But listen to me, you cannot let someone compromise your mentality and your peace because you're worried about saving them, okay? The people that you come in contact with, some of them are meant to be loved at a distance, and that is okay. Sometimes you are going to have to cut people off or cut people out of your close circle, and that is okay. If you are paying a price, like I said, because their negativity or their way of life, whatever it might be, their bad energy is affecting you on a personal level, you cannot hold yourself responsible to try to change them or save them, whatever you want to call it. That is not on you, and you need to protect your energy. You're only ever going to be in charge of one person's energy, and that is your own. And everything about your energy stems from your heart, so you need to guard and be wise with who you share your energy with. It is too precious to give to people in situations that do not deserve it. What and who you allow to infiltrate your mentality will be seen in the fruit that you produce. I know, especially as someone who is extremely emotional and empathetic and loving and caring and just wanting to help other people, it is extremely difficult to close a door on a relationship. You feel guilty, you feel bad, you feel like you failed at changing them, you feel like you did something, somehow you're at fault for causing this divide. But listen to me, you have to distance yourself from people who are toxic to you, who have ill intent towards you, who do not have your best interest at heart. Why would you want these people around you anyway in your circle if they don't really respect or care about you as it is? Okay, and so I might be getting, you know, more on one extreme where these situations are a little more drastic, where you're having to like cut someone that you had a prior relationship with or building a relationship with out of your circle. It's not always that drastic. Literally protecting your energy could be you have to unfollow someone on Instagram, and not because of that person, not because that person wronged you in any way, but because maybe their content that they post, it makes you compare yourself to them. It makes you envious, something like that. Or even if it is the fact that you never call a guy who, you know, asks you on a date because you just don't have a really good feeling about the situation. That is you deciding to protect your energy, because there again, it's too precious to just give away to these things that have not earned it or deserve it. This right here is your mental, emotional, spiritual temple, okay? You have every right to guard this. Your heart and your mind are the harvesters of your environment. So whatever is sowed and reaped is going to be directly dependent on what you allow to be planted and to grow in your mentality. This is not to say that it is okay to badmouth someone or have resentment or anger or bitterness built up towards someone, but you need to do an honest evaluation. And if there are people or a person or even a situation in your life that is not feeding you positivity, it's not life-giving, it's not growing you, then and especially if it's doing the opposite, if it's negatively changing the way that you think, it's causing you fear and anxiety and anger, any bad emotions, even doubt, it is okay to cut it off. You cannot afford to pour love and energy into people who have no interest in reciprocating it. Again, to all my Christians out there, listen to me. It is okay that you don't vibe with everyone well. Not everyone is gonna click and match with you, and that is okay. Some people you need to love and pray for from a distance. That Jesus will understand, okay? I promise. You have to think of it this way. What good are you gonna be to yourself or other people that do need you if you are allowing this negative toxicity to change and alter your being? So go unfollow that person, write a respectful letter, don't text back. Whatever it is, your peace is too precious and you don't owe it to anyone. So don't let someone take it from you. Again, not from an extreme, but let's say it's you. You're the person that someone cuts off from their life. You're going to be hurt. You're going to be angry, and you have every right to be, because you didn't want that to happen. That's not what you were expecting from the situation. But just for a second, try to take a step back and put yourself in their shoes and honestly ask yourself, what were you contributing to their life? Because when you look at it, you might have been causing more pain, more anger, more fear or anxiety than anything else. So can you really blame that person for wanting to let your energy go? No, you can't. And you have to remember that this comes in seasons, this comes in cycles. What one person's energy was contributing to your life in one season may not be needed in the next, and vice versa. And this is okay, this is a part of life, but you need to recognize, and like I said, try not to get too upset, try not to get too hurt if it happens to you or if you do it to someone, and understand that it's a natural give and take, that just sometimes energies are going to clash, and that is okay. So protect your energy. You alone are in control of what you allow to speak to your mind and your heart. So protect your energy. You alone are in control of what you allow to infiltrate and speak to your heart. All right, y'all, and in typical vlog fashion, I want to end this with a really, really great quote that came from one of my best friends, Rochelle, who I work with currently. I was going through a situation and, you know, talking to her back and forth about it. And she said this really beautiful quote that I think a lot of us should hold on to and use in situations in our lives when we maybe need to cut off some negative energy. And she says, quote, "Not everyone is meant for our energy, and that's okay. But when two energy sources are conflicting, they need to part ways so that they can light up others in more compatible ways," end quote. So to all of you watching this, just please remember, you don't owe anyone your energy that you don't want to give to. And remember too that, you know, bad vibes and things, they might be temporary, or, you know, if you're seeing a really long pattern of this stuff creeping in, then you need to cut it off and get rid of it and see how much more fruitful and how much more successful and happier you are without that bad energy following you around and invading your mind. All right, y'all. So with that being said, that is it for me. I appreciate you all for watching so much. Please be sure to subscribe to my channel if you have not already. The button is right below this video. If you like this content, please be sure to give me a thumbs up. And as always, please be sure to comment anything and everything in the comment section below. I want to hear from you guys. And my social media is popping up on the screen right now, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Make sure to follow me if you don't already. Okay, guys, thanks so much again for watching, and I'll see you next week.